In the name of our risen Lord, welcome to Trinity Lutheran London Worship on YouTube for August 30th, the 13th Sunday in Pentecost. You can find the words for the hymns and responses on your screen, so you can respond and sing along. Join us now with song and joy, and thank you for joining us. It's Vern Leffler and my wife, Joan.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. God of compassion, you have opened the way for us and brought us to yourself. Pour your love into our hearts, that, overflowing with joy, we may freely share the blessings of your realm and faithfully proclaim the good news of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Genesis chapter 18, verses 1 to 15. The Lord appeared to Abram by the oaks of Mamre, as he sat at the entrance of his tent in the heat of the day. He looked up and saw three men standing near him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent entrance to meet them and bowed down to the ground. He said, "My Lord, if I find favor with you, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought and wash your feet and rest yourselves under the tree. Let me bring a little bread that you may refresh yourselves, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant." So they said, "Do as you have said." And Abram hastened into the tent to Sarah and said, "Make ready quickly 3 measures of choice flour, knead it and make cakes." Abram ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to the servant, who hastened to prepare it. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them, and he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, "Where is your wife Sarah?" And he said, "There in the tent." Then one said, "I will surely return to you in due season, and your wife Sarah shall have a son." And Sarah was listening at the tent entrance behind him. Now Abraham and Sarah were old, advanced in age. It had ceased to be with Sarah after the manner of women. So Sarah laughed to herself, saying, "After I have grown old and my husband is old, shall I have pleasure?" The Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Shall I indeed bear a child now that I am old?' Is anything too wonderful for the Lord? At the set time, I will return to you in due season, and Sarah shall have a son." But Sarah denied laughing, saying, "I did not laugh," for she was afraid. He said, "Oh yes, you did laugh." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Did you hear about the little nun who went on a much anticipated mission, an assignment to the Apache tribe? And she was so excited that she drove past the last gas station without noticing that she was almost out of gas. About a mile down the road, she ran out of gas and had to walk all the way back to the gas station. The attendant told her he'd love to help her, but he didn't have a container to put the gas into. However, he was sympathetic to her plight, and he agreed that he'd search in the old shed round the back to see if there was something that might work. And the only container that he could find was an old bedpan. But the grateful nun took it and said with the bedpan would work just fine, and they put the gas into the car and she carried it back ever so carefully, making sure not to spill a drop. And she got to the car and she poured in carefully as she could and from the bedpan into the tank. And a truck driver comes pulling along and sees the nun emptying the container into the tank, and he rolled out his window and he shouted, "I wish I had your faith, sister." So there's a man talking to God, and he says, "Hey, God, how long is 1,000,000 years? And God answers, "To me, it's about 1 minute. "Well, God, how much is $1,000,000? "To me, it's about 1 penny. So the man says, "Hey, God, can I have 1 penny? And God says, "Sure, just wait 1 minute. Laughter's good, right? Some people say that Jesus did not have a sense of humor, and there's no evidence of humor in anything that Jesus says or does. I would disagree. I think that he did. There's the parable that Jesus told of the slave that owed the master a lot of money. Do you remember that one? He owes him a whole pile of money, and his master forgives him, and a fellow slave owes him a little bit of money and he doesn't forgive him. That's the parable. But I think it starts with a joke. So Jesus told the parable of the slave with the master that owed a lot of money, like a really big amount of money. 10,000 talents. Can you imagine that? No? Well, a talent is worth about 16 years of wages. So, taking a book out of, using the current minimum wage in Ontario, not the Kathleen Wynne proposed one, just makes it a little bit higher. 10,000 talents worth about $3.5 million. That's $3.5 billion. That's what 10,000 talents is worth. Ontario's debt's about $312 billion, so somewhere around a tenth of Ontario's debt. That's what this slave owed his master. So I think it might have gone more like this. And Jesus said, so there was this farm laborer, and he owed the farmer like a lot of money. And the disciples said, how much, Jesus? And Jesus said, well, like a lot. And the disciples, they know to play along with this, and they roll their eyes. They're like, how much? A lot, Jesus. And Jesus says, like $3.5 billion. And the disciples are rolling on the floor laughing. Funny, right? A slave owes his master $3.5 billion. Yeah, like, whatever. You get the picture. Exaggeration is a common form of humor. And I think there's humor in our lesson for today, the Genesis one that we were reading. So three men walk into a tent. Well, no, not that kind of humor. But three men did walk into a tent. I guess they walked under a tree to take some rest, to be precise. And Adam says, hey, why don't you take a load off your feet? Wait here. So Abraham goes to find his wife Sarah and says, hey, Sarah, let's get a little water for our guests' feet. And maybe a little bread, too. Get some flour and knead it and make cakes. And Sarah rolls her eyes and says, how much flour, Abram? And Abram says, well, like a lot. And Sarah says, oh, is your nephew coming too? Get it? Lot? There you go. And Abraham says, that's not what I meant. I mean, like a lot of flour, like for cakes and for our guests. And Sarah grins and says, like, how much flour, Abraham? And Abraham sighs, having never made a bread cake. In his 99 years of all of his life, he's never made a bread cake. Sarah, I don't know. How about three measures? We've got three guests, so three measures. And Sarah falls to the ground, laughing her head off. And Abraham looks puzzled and goes, what? What's so funny? And Sarah snorts, three measures is about 30 ephah. And then you all fall on the floor laughing, right? Get it? Well, let me tell you, three measures of flour is about 560 pounds of flour, enough to make about 900 loaves of bread. So Abraham has asked her to go and get enough flour for 900 loaves. So Sarah eventually gets up off the floor, holding her sides, and it might take her a while because she's 90 years old at this point. She's almost as old as Abraham. And the three men from the outside, they hear the laughter and they call out, hey, Abraham, is that Sarah laughing in there? Where is she? She's right here, calls out Abraham. And one of the men says, hey, Abraham, we're going to be back in 9 months and your Sarah's going to have a baby boy. And Sarah starts to laugh yet again. And she snickers to herself, I'm 90. I'm going to have a baby, and he's 99, and he will give me pleasure? Ha, right. And God says, hey, Sarah, so you've worked it out, okay? You know there's a joke coming. If it starts with hey and the person's name, you know there's a joke coming, right? So God says, hey, Sarah, why did you laugh? And at this point, God and Abraham both start rolling on the floor, laughing their heads off. What Sarah doesn't know is that God and Abraham
had already talked about this. God told Abraham in the previous chapter that God would give them a baby boy and to call him Isaac. Isaac means laughter. So there's the joke. Isaac in Hebrew means laughter. God and Abraham were already in on this joke. They'd shared this joke. A man and a woman in their 90s are going to have a baby? Now that's funny. I don't know how much of you know the short forms for texting, right? There's a rolling on the floor, laughing your face off, right? Okay, and those that really know the texting will correct me later. Some people know it. Some people know it. And I think this must be the first time that this has ever happened. This is the first biblical occurrence of somebody rolling on the floor, laughing their face off. Because I'm going to read you exactly what it says from chapter 18. Then Abraham fell on his face and laughed, and he said to himself, "Can a child be born to a man who is 100 years old? Can Sarah, who is 90 years old, bear a child?" Meanwhile, he's rolling on the floor, laughing his face off. Now, in our North European culture, that's kind of where our Lutheran church is coming out for, and our, like, often way too serious piety about all of these scripture things, I think we take this story about the 90-year-olds and the God's miracle way too seriously, and that God is chastising Sarah for laughing. Is that what you hear? Is that what you've heard in the past? And I think what you hear is something that kind of goes like this. Sarah Jane Goldman, and you know you're in trouble, and you know God's got you in trouble when you hear all of your names being used. Sarah Jane Goldman, how dare you laugh? Is anything too wonderful for the Lord? Maybe that's the way you've heard it in the past. Maybe that's because we were raised in these northern climates. You know, when it gets dark and cold for such a long period of time. Maybe it's kind of like emotional permafrost that kind of freezes our hearts up. And hey, congregation, just joshing with you. But maybe rather we should hear it this way. Maybe we should hear God and Abraham sharing this inside joke. Did you hear about the couple who were 90 years old who were about to have their first baby together and they called him laughter? That's kind of funny. Maybe what we're hearing today is that God is having some fun with us too, bringing laughter to the world. And laughter is always good medicine, bringing joy to a childless couple. Maybe also what we're hearing is God is bringing God's joy and laughter in celebrating life, celebrating new birth, new joy, new life, celebrating promises fulfilled. Because God told them before, "We will make a great nation of you." Because what we're hearing today, with our reading of this, we're hearing a day 8 story. And I hear you all rolling your eyes, right? That was a joke. Hear you rolling your eyes. Because you're doing it so loudly. What's a day 8 story, Pastor Steve? Well, a day 8 story comes from that device right down there. How many sides are there on a font? There's 8. God made the world in 7 days and rested on the 7th day. That's our pattern for how our life goes. And then we start again. The next day is the 8th day. We live past that creation in the continuation of creation, which is why our font has 8 sides. We are day 8 people as we get baptized and live into that 8th day and the rest of the days that come after. And I'm not denying, not even for a moment, that there is pain and suffering in the world. We could fill every Sunday talking about pain and suffering in the world. And I'm also not saying, don't worry, be happy. Your worry is real and your fears are real. But what I'm talking about this morning is God is celebrating with us, and God also is a joy, is a God of happiness, joy, and laughter. The same God that walks with us when we're suffering and carries us when we're there, carries us when things are tough, carries us when things are fair, also wants to laugh and celebrate with us. The same God that celebrates Jim being Father of the Year. The same God that celebrates Father Kevin Dixon. How many of you know Kevin Dixon? He's preached here a few times. Well, he just got married last month and is a stepfather now. So I wished him this morning Happy Father's Day, because this is his first set of children. He's now a stepdad. The same God that celebrates with Kadun, our refugee, the father of the refugee family, and their little baby that just got born on Friday. That same God is the model for all good fathers around the world, loving, caring, providing, and bringing joy and laughter to those around us. So, congregation, hey, congregation, now you know something funny is about to happen. But we're going to share the peace right after. We're not even going to sing the song. We will sing that after we've shared the peace. We're going to share the peace right now, and I'm going to ask you to do something else. I want you, when you greet someone else, greet the people that you will meet this morning, and it will take a little longer than normal, I would imagine. I want you to greet them and share with them something of joy that you have either recently encountered or something that you remember from the past that has given you great joy and laughter. And I'm thinking about what Prince and George did here last Sunday. They get up and they told us about achievements and things that have happened in their life, and we all applauded and just woohooed with them. It was wonderful, shared in their joy. Prince had earned his degree in social work, his bachelor's degree in social work. And George, you had some fabulous news. You have a groundbreaking coming up for your new house in August. August? July? In July. We will put it in the newsletter and in the bulletin. And you invited us all to come along. How many rooms in your house? How many bedrooms? 6 bedrooms, right? God will bless you and make a nation of you too, right? So we're going to do that this morning. We're going to share with Joe. I'm just pulling my phone out because there's something very, very important on here. And I'm going to tell you a little story about on Friday. I took my daughter Amy up to Toronto, and she went up to visit with her longest friend, her friend from high school. They've known each other since they were 13, so that's like 20 years they've known each other. And this is Kim. And Kim and Scott asked me to do their wedding 5 years ago. So I did their wedding in a beautiful little ceremony, very few people there, but they asked me to do the wedding, and I did. And Kim had some difficulty with her recent pregnancy, but recently, about 3 weeks ago, they had their first little baby. And that's who we went to visit as well on Friday. So I do have a photograph in here that I am going to share with you as we share peace. I got to hold this little baby from my daughter's oldest friend, and I did their wedding. And so this has been 20 years in the making. And a great nation, I guess, may come from them as well. So that's what I'm going to share with you now. So please, when we do our exchange of peace, share with one another a story of joy that is in your life. The peace of Christ, the joy of Christ be with you always. Let's share.
So that sermon was recorded 3 years ago. Man, did I ever sound young. I miss it, actually, that chance to converse with you and interact. So here I am back in front of a boring old microphone and just me and a big screen in front of me. But there's a continuation from that sermon. So on that day, we hung out with each other and shared the peace and shared some stories of good news. So I want to do the same thing 3 years later. And in this moment of lockdown, where are you finding joy? Can you share a story of joy? And let's put those together and we'll share them next week. And we'll put together a lovely sort of, here's where we're finding joy in this moment of lockdown, because God comes to us with joy. God brings us laughter like he brought to Sarah and Abraham. They weren't expecting to have a baby, and there it was. They got joy. They got Isaac. They got laughter. So where are you finding joy? Where are you finding laughter? Share it with me so that we can share with the whole congregation. Send a photograph, maybe with a caption or something with it. Make a recording on your cell phone and tell me your story, or write me an email. Either way, I will find ways to do that. And if you're stuck and you're not quite sure what to do, call me up. There's the phone number. You know it. Or send me an email on the address shown there. So I look forward to hearing your stories this week, and we'll put them together and have fun next week. And we'll lift up our hearts and we'll share joy. Amen.
Lord, in the midst of virus and pandemic, we pray for and thank all those who put themselves at risk for the greater good of our communities. From grocery store workers to doctors and nursing staff, for those who work in nursing and retirement homes, for the teachers going back to teach, protect them and encourage them. Lord, listen to your children praying. We pray for all those in or near our community who need uplifting and comfort. We pray for Lou Mantle, Margan Dawn Cook, Marianne Stewart, Gunther Sturm, Al Barrett, husband of Carol at home, Richard Jackman, husband of Nancy, Deborah Kenny and Bobby Mantle, son and daughter of Sharon and Lou, Steve Hodgins, son-in-law of Linda Reynolds, Pastor Julio at home in Niagara, Jack Kells, son of Madeline at home, Frida Paler, friend of the congregation. We pray for the family and friends of Susan Payetz, who died on 23rd August. Lord, have mercy upon her and let perpetual light shine upon her. Lord, listen to your children praying. We also pray for those in the Thames ministry area, especially Reverend John Goldsworthy and the members of St. John's Aylmer, whatever their needs may be. Lord, listen to your children praying.
Together with the church around the world, let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
As our offerings arrive at the church, via the mail, by people dropping things off, or over the internet, we give you thanks to God for the offerings that our community brings. Let us pray. Providing God, we return these gifts to you, our time, our talents, our treasures. Use them and use us for the sustaining of your ministry through our Trinity congregation to share the good news and to glorify your holy name. Amen. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
By your word you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts. Freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness. Forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God,
we give you thanks and praise.
Send your spirit of truth, O God, rekindle your gifts within us, renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love for the sake of a world in need. Faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray with the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord bless you.
May the Lord keep you.
May the Lord keep you.
Make his face to shine.
Make his face to shine.
Shine upon you.
Shine upon you.
And may he be gracious to you.